know that everybody talks about the millions of gallons of water that are needed to cool these data centers, but how much electricity do they need to do all that processing, like this Microsoft one in Mount Pleasant?
It varies quite a bit by data center and the type of data center, but the Mount Pleasant data center, I think, is supposed to use about 450 megawatts of power, and that is a lot. That's about the same amount as all the households in Milwaukee together. Mm-hmm. So it's not like there are hundreds and hundreds of megawatts of power that is just like kind of laying around being waiting to be used. Mm-hmm. And so we don't necessarily have the capacity to meet all that demand as it is today. And so we are going to need new infrastructure, new transmission lines, new power plants in order to meet that demand.
So what about the cost of this energy demand and then that infrastructure of which you speak? Does that get passed along to the consumer? Like, am I going to see it in my electric bill?
So you can imagine that when more people want something, the price sometimes tend to go up because there's maybe a limit to the supply of that. Of electricity. But also the way utilities do things is that they build infrastructure to meet the demand of their customers, how the utilities will do things, and also what kind of contracts these companies are able to get with the utilities. A lot of that will determine how energy bills will or might change.